In PyVision 2020, you can create on-the-fly calculations so you can analyze a process in real time. I'm Jeff Resnick with OSI Soft Learning, and today we'll take a look at PyVision calculations. You'll notice that our left-hand pane in PyVision has an added tab for calculations. Here we can build out quick calculations to get added insight from our displays. This includes summary calculations like minimum, maximum, and average, basic arithmetic operators, and PyVision calculations also supports using performance equation functions. You can use a calculation on any PyVision symbol or configuration that supports a data item. Currently, the calculations feature supports Py points. Let's go take a look at an example, and I'll get a few of my Py points to work with. On this display, I'm looking at the overall function of a production line in my plant. I have some OEE, overall equipment effectiveness, metrics on the left, and it looks like the actual calculation for OEE is failing. I could troubleshoot the analysis and figure out the root cause, but I really want to know the result now, and I can see all the information that I need is available and working, so I'm going to make a calculation. On the calculation tab, I'll click on the plus sign to create a new calculation. I'll give it a name of OEE, and OEE is defined as quality times availability times performance, and then quantified as a percentage. I'll look up my Py points by only searching through my data archive, and if I search for Fulton, line 5, then I'll find my Py points. I can drag and drop them onto the calculation editor. By default, the editor will add the Py point values together, but I'll switch it to multiplication, and then we'll divide by 10,000 to get the right amount of decimal places for my percentage. There are some advanced options as well. We can have a custom time interval to sample over. We can also make a resulting plot appear as stepped for discrete calculations. Or, if you're doing a total, we have a conversion factor to add in. I'll keep the calculation simple for now, and we'll click Save. Now we see the calculation, OEE, is listed, and there are two dashes to the right of it indicating it's not currently shown in the display. To see its values, we can drag it out like any other data item in PyVision, and I'll make another radial gauge to keep with the display theme. Now we can see that we get a check mark because the OEE calculation is listed on this display. By default, the radial gauge range will use database units, which calculations don't have, so I'll have to put in a custom range. And I'll make the style match the other symbols by changing the angle. To finish it off, I'll use a text box to add the percentage unit. And now I have a working OEE calculation on my display. If I were interested in mapping the values over time, I could use a trend symbol to show my calculation. And I can add in a few more columns so I can see the min, max, and average appear in the trend too. For one more step, if I was interested in the results at a particular hour, I'll give my calculation a time interval, and you can see how the trend updates. I'll change the time range and show you the calculation updates. And as a secret between you and me, I have a working calculation that uses a Py analysis, so let's double check that we have the correct result. Looks good to me. There you have it, a calculation on the fly that can help me gain insight from my data in real time.